Now here is an example of a dead shopping center. In the industry, I believe dead refers to a shopping center or shopping mall where over 50% of the stores are closed and vacant. And this one certainly meets that criteria. This building here used to be a Channel Lumber, and then that closed and it became a Staples. Staples split off this end of it here, and that became a Petco pet store. And then those both closed and moved to a new shopping center a couple miles down the road. And then they built this Circuit City, or actually The City, which is supposed to be a smaller version of Circuit City. But Circuit City went bankrupt just before this store was supposed to open. I believe that was back in 2007. So this has never actually been open as a Circuit City. What it does every year, it becomes a Halloween store around that time. That's really the only use this building has seen in the past couple years. And of course, there's much more than that in this shopping center. The next building over here does have a Radio Shack that's open, but there's space for, looks like, one other store that has been vacant since the 1990s at least. So just Radio Shack there and empty space. Here's an IHOP, which used to be a Roy Rogers back in the day, then it became an IHOP. It's still open, still doing pretty good. And here's another strip mall building. You can see there used to be a Ruby Tuesdays. They closed maybe 5 or 6 years ago. And the funny thing is, before they blocked all those windows out, you could see they left the lights on, and the lights were glowing for years after it closed. There looks like there's 3 vacant stores there. Then there's a Subway. The Subway's, I think there used to be a laundromat next to the Subway, but they're the only thing left there. Another vacant store with some kind of ornate front door on it. I don't know what it used to be. You can see the sign is totally blacked out because it used to say Kmart and Pathmark. Both of those are now closed. This is the Kmart. They built this big auto center back in the 90s, I would guess, and then that is all vacant. The Garden Center. That sign, that wall there used to say Valley Fair on it before they painted over it, because that's what the store was before it was Kmart, I would guess, back in the 70s. Maybe 60s when they first built this whole thing. So this closed a couple years ago. It's been vacant since then. You see where the sign used to be. Now this is the most popular part of the whole shopping center, is this retro fitness gym. There used to be a dollar store next to it on that side, and on that side used to be a shoe store. Those both closed within the past year or so. Here's where the Pathmark supermarket used to be. So that's all vacant. And then finally at the end here, there used to be a Chase Bank, and the other open store there left is the Discount Liquors. Here's one place I haven't been since I was a little kid, probably. The back of this whole place. There's the back of the Pathmark. Nothing around there anymore. Except kids using it for skateboarding. This is the building with the Subway in it. And this was a later addition. It used to be all parking lot here. This place had a massive parking lot, as typical for places built in the 60s and 70s. They really overestimated how much the population would grow. And this is the place with the Radio Shack in it. It didn't used to be here either. It used to be more parking lot. There's the never opened Circuit City.
one last look at the city sign. And the only reason this place hasn't fallen into total disrepair is because they have security guards monitoring it all the time. So, looks like they keep up on the maintenance pretty good. Even though, obviously, most of it is empty. And here's your look as I pass by on the highway here. You can see how long the whole thing is. I don't know if you could get a good perspective from up close. Definitely a pretty big shopping center. Now mostly vacant. This is on Route 22 in North Plainfield, New Jersey.